Welcome to Christ Way Church. Here's Pastor Annu with today's message.
Recognize your spiritual hunger and feed on righteousness.
A man born on this earth has two lives which goes together. When he lead a physical life, a spiritual life goes along with it, whether he is aware of it or not. Spiritual life is a life that connected with the human spirit. Many understand this, so they connect it with religion, learning about God and following rituals and are mandatory in many homes around the world. Most of the people belonging to a religion and learn spiritual matters in their early age through their spiritual institution. These efforts are one way good and helpful to learn about spiritual matters. As long as they teach spiritual matters, they learn. But after their studies, they do their rituals and forget to implement the spiritual things in their daily life. Spiritual life is something that is natural and normal. And spirituality is in a daily life. A man should experience the presence of God, the existence of God, the favor of God, the mercy of God in his life. We give more importance to priority to our physical life and its growth, and we ignore spiritual life. We don't have to go to a forest or live a solitude life to lead a spiritual life. While living our normal life, we should have relationship and fellowship with the creator of this world through our spirit. Our spirit always want to do right, but and the spiritual life is not a religious life, or spiritual life is not the practicing rituals, but spiritual life is available only for those who are willing to do righteousness and willing to correct themselves and lead a steady growth in different areas of their life as their creator expect from them, or the as per the commandments of the creator. Spiritual life means spiritual life seems very tough for those who do evil and they don't want to correct their life and lead a spiritual life. Many have got a wrong idea about spiritual life. As I told you, many feel that spiritual life means a religious life or a life that is led by rituals. We need to change different areas of our life as per the requirement of God. This is the truth which we cannot ignore. God is not asking any ritual to follow to lead a spiritual life. Self-awareness is a must to lead a spiritual life. We look outwardly righteous and pious, but inwardly we are sinful and corrupt. Human beings are created with a hunger to live a right relationship with God Almighty. A self-desire to correct oneself is the core of this relationship, because only through inward righteousness we can have a relationship with the God. Only through inward righteousness we can live a spiritual life. Matthew 5:6, Jesus said, "Blessed are those who hunger and thirst for righteousness, but they shall be satisfied," or they shall be filled. This verses look very tough and hard for people who don't understand, but listen to me carefully what Jesus Christ means here. Jesus compares righteousness to food here. He says, blessed are those who hunger and thirst for righteousness. They are satisfied, they are filled. So Jesus compares righteousness to food here. Without food and drink, we die, because the life of our body depends on food, and we are what we eat. Nutritions tell us that our appetite determines our diet, and our diet determines our intake, and our intake determines our health. Why is hungering and thirsting such a good illustration in the spiritual realm? Hunger and thirst are natural expression of the basic human desire and need for food and water, because As water and food is to the body, so the righteousness is to the spiritual life. One of the clear indications that something is wrong physically is when we lose our appetite, isn't it? It is the same with spiritual life also. To hunger and thirst for righteousness and for God is at the very root of our being. It is the way God made us. When there is no hunger, it is an indicator that something is wrong with us spiritually, because what? Because that hunger is so basic for human nature. Hunger is so basic for human nature, basic for the physical life as well as for the spiritual life. Whether you are aware of it or whether you believe it or not, you are leading a spiritual life. Please understand. Because God has created spirit in every man to live a spiritual life. In your ignorance, you are not living your spiritual life correctly. That's all the difference. You are living a wrong spiritual life, whether you believe it or not. And Jesus is saying this, righteousness is as vital to spiritual life as food and drink is to the physical life. Without righteousness, you cannot live spiritually, just like without food, you cannot live physically. And we need to have a hunger to be free from sin, selfishness, pride, ego, anger, unforgiveness, jealousy, impatience, rudeness, bitterness, drunkenness, etc., as Galatians 5:19-21 explains. As human beings, we naturally hunger for more of money, position, status, education, vacation, power, success, comfort, happiness, etc. And when we have that hunger, we see that we will try to achieve them. At the same time, human beings are created with the hunger to live a right relationship with God. Whether you believe it or not, as I told you, until we experience this relationship, there is always a spiritual hunger that is there inside unsatisfied. When we come into right relationship with God, we find the purpose and meaning of our life. Jesus uses the metaphors of eating and drinking as the motivating power to live a righteous life. No one can force to eat. And the old proverb is true. You can lead a horse to water, but you cannot make him drink. Like food, you have to want to have righteousness in your life. The verbs for hunger and thirst mean an intense desire, a burning craving, all-consuming pursuit. It is as though you are dry and parched and nothing will stop you from getting to the water fountain to drink. Or you are so hungry you will pursue food at any cost. It is a desperate kind of hunger. Hunger and thirst are intense desires. It is that same intensity that we need to seeking righteousness, because in every human heart there is a spiritual hunger. Without your knowledge, there is a hunger. Today what I am teaching is you should recognize that hunger, whether you believe it. That's the reason I told you, whatever I am teaching, whatever Jesus says, whether you believe it or not, whether you are an atheist, it is true. So there is a spiritual hunger in every human being, but they are not able to understand it. Psalms 84:1-7 is true for everyone, where Psalmist says, his soul longs and faints for the move of the Lord. Blessed are those whose strength is in the Lord, he says. Now, what happens when you take food? What happens when you take drink? Before that food is going to do anything, it has to be internalized. That is, it has to be digested. So Jesus is saying that you must not only desire for the righteousness, but you must take righteousness and internalize it. When you feed on righteousness, when you consciously doing righteousness in the place of unrighteousness, which our flesh always do, you absorb this righteousness in such a way that it becomes the part of you. Righteousness must be absorbed into your being in the same way that the food you eat is absorbed into your body. It becomes part of you, when you eat the food, it is broken down by your digestive system into the different biochemical molecules, proteins, carbohydrates and fat. These molecules will nourish every part of your body, isn't it? The piece of food causes you, or piece of food causes you to get strength, or it become the food that you are eating will become the part of you and it becomes strength, and that's the reason today you are seated here. You are able to get up and walk, isn't it? Without food, people cannot get up and walk. Your health will be deteriorating. At the spiritual level, we have to do the same thing with righteousness. We should not only understand about the righteousness or the importance of righteousness, we have to pray and try hard to do the righteousness and the will of God in our everyday life. Righteousness has to be absorbed and internalized so that it goes into every part of our being and every part of our life. That will be a way of life. So once we start practicing righteousness, that will be the way of life. For example, self-control in every area of your life. Strengthen your spiritual life. Strengthen the relationship with God. But if you don't have self-control, if you are finding it difficult to control yourself, understand you are going away and away from God. That is how the whole full humanity is. Like, nutritious food gives us energy and health and our body grows strongly. Exercising self-control and doing the will of God will strengthen our relationship with God and we grow spiritually. Jesus says in John 6:57, whoever feeds on me will live because of me. Feeding on Jesus Christ means feeding on the word of God. John 1:1-14. It is not enough just to receive Jesus Christ into our heart. We have to obey every word of God that he commands to us. John 3:17, Jesus said, God has sent Jesus into this world in order that the world might be saved through him. John 12:47, he said, he will not judge those who obey his word. That means we must know that God is a righteous judge and God will judge our action. From morning till evening, what we are doing, God is watching. Even in the hiding and the secret place, God is watching. And he will judge our action. And he will reward and punish. He will reward or punish according to our action. James 4:12 and James 5:9 and Romans 6:2-8 says, he will render to each one according to his work. For those who are self-seeking and do not obey the truth and obey unrighteousness, there will be wrath and fury for the entire humanity, including the born-again believers. A relationship with God begins with faith in Christ, and faith in Christ is more than believing information about Jesus Christ. It is coming to Jesus Christ to live a righteous life. I always tell you, otherwise you don't need Jesus Christ. You don't need Jesus Christ. You don't turn to Jesus Christ. You don't born again, baptized to live your old life. You don't need Holy Spirit to go back and lead your old life, isn't it? You need Holy Spirit to do what you cannot do. What is that we cannot do? The righteousness of God. Then who can say that we cannot do the righteousness of God? So, righteous life we have to live amongst our co-workers, friends and family members and in this whole world. Psalms 37:17 says, righteous cry out and God hears and delivers them out of all their troubles. Believe that. Yes, we are in trouble. We need God's help. Will God won't help us? Yes, for that we have to live a righteous life. Many of you won't believe that. That's the reason always you go in the presence of God. You don't ask for the righteousness, but you ask to deliver you from your troubles. And verses 25 says, Psalms 34:27, God will not forsake righteous and his descendants begging bread. Verses 39 says, in times of trouble, God will strengthen the righteous And Psalms 55:22 says, He will never allow righteous to be shaken. And Proverbs 3:7-8 and Proverbs 4:20-22 says, Obedience to the word of God reward us health to the body and nourishment to the bones. Please understand. How can you avoid medicine? How can you stop going to hospitals? Start obeying God. You don't believe? That is the truth. Exodus 15:26 says, If you listen to the Lord your God and do what is right in His eyes, and if you pay attention to His commandment and keep His decrees, He will bring on you any of the disease that He brought. He will not bring on you any of the disease that He has brought to the Egyptians. Egyptians means people don't follow God. And God says, I am the God who healeth thee. I am the God who heals you. God not only forgives our sins, He will heal our sin, His sickness. Please understand, my friends, if you have faith in God that He can forgive your sins, understand He can heal your sickness. And He will not lead you to sickness. It is not that He will lead you to sickness and heal you. He will give you a healthy body. As creation, we should fear God who can destroy our soul and body in hell. Matthew 10:28. Now notice this. Hunger and thirst express what? Intensity. Isn't it? When a person is hungry and thirsty, he will sacrifice a lot to get what he needs, and he is ready to walk a long distance to get food and drink, and he has no other choice. And once he gets it, he is energized and satisfied. Jesus said, Blessed are those who hunger and thirst for righteousness. Many people today are looking for satisfaction in all the wrong places. Trying to satisfy the craving of our heart with junk of this world, like movies, parties, sex, pornography, boyfriend, girlfriends, another wife, after marriage, another girlfriend, another boyfriend, another job, fun, entertainment for a time, etc. All these will never satisfy us, and they are the junk food and for the human spirit. Many of us here have filled our heart with all these many of these junk food. No wonder we are not happy. Are you satisfied? Are you happy? Even after you are born again, are you satisfied in Jesus Christ? What is rising in you? Faith in God or doubt in God? Tell me, my friends, if you are not satisfied, you will have doubt about every word that is written in the Bible. Hallelujah. If you live a righteous life, you know that every word that is written in the Bible is true. Jesus told, Heaven and earth will pass away, but His word will come to pass. They will never pass away. Understand, my friends, God is the God who healeth us. Please understand, I have only one prayer. All those who are coming to this church should not go to a doctor, should not be in the sick bed. This I pray, but you have to respond. If you just consider me to be a funny lady, a crack lady, and hear from one ear and go from other, definitely, you have to, what Bible says, God will render every person according to his action. Don't blame anyone for your problem and your troubles and your sickness. What we sow, we have to reap. So no wonder people jump from one job to another, from one relationship to another, still falling short of what their heart desire. Because as human beings, we are far too easily pleased. We think so often that the things of this world will satisfy us. Jesus is the only one who can satisfy us and refresh us and can fill our emptiness. Grammatically, Jesus expressed these two verses, to hunger and to thirst, as the present participles, which implies continuous actions. He said, Blessed are those who hunger and thirst for righteousness, they shall be filled. Those who are filled are not those who have their hunger and thirst met, but those who are continually hungering and thirsting for the righteousness till they die. A person doesn't stop hungering and thirsting for physical food, isn't it? It is the same for righteousness in the spiritual life. For the spiritual food, once he or she is crossed the line of faith, it is a constant pursuit to live a righteous life, to yearn more and more for righteousness. Psalms 42, 1 and 2 says, in this way, as the deer pants for the water, even we sing this song, so my soul long after you. Do you mean when you sing this song? Or you are singing for the sake of tune? So what we should be, so we should not be weary for doing righteousness among the sinfulness of the people. That's the reason Galatians 6, 9 and 2 Thessalonians 3, 12 says that we should not be weary of doing good. Most of us are getting tired of doing good, but we should never be tired. We should only be hungry and thirsty for more of righteousness, more to forgive the people, more to love the people who don't like us, and more to adjust with the people whom it is difficult to bear with. As the life is getting tough, you should ask more of righteousness. What you need is more of righteousness. Otherwise, you will be tired of the life. Psalm 63:1 says, O God, you are my God. Earnestly I seek you. My soul thirsts for you. My body longs for you in a dry and weary land where there is no water. How then can we begin to develop the hunger for God? How do we recognize the hunger of our soul, as we cannot ignore this hunger? I told you this hunger is in everyone, whether you believe it or not. So how can we recognize this hunger inside of us? How do we develop this hunger? The best way to look at this hunger of our soul and understand is to make a comparison to physical hunger and the way we handle it. When we get hungry, we naturally look for something to satisfy our hunger, isn't it? At least we look for a bar of chocolate or a snack that will take away the feeling of hunger, isn't it? Spiritually speaking, this hunger for God, which God has put in our being, is often not recognized for what it is. It may be an empty feeling, a sense of longing, even loneliness in the midst of the people. Friends, you are feeling it. You have to feel it. If you are a human being with all sense, you have to feel it. Please understand. I always tell you, my message is to live a daily life peacefully, joyfully, successfully. If you listen to my messages and obey them, definitely you can live a successful life, a peaceful life, a joyful life. You will never say that life is hard. You will testify that God is living and God is for you. God, Jesus Christ died only for you. You will testify, my friends. So you will feel this emptiness. You feel lonely even in the midst of your people. Isn't it? You lack joy and peace. You feel like dying. You feel fed up of life. Why, you know? This is because your soul is thirsty. Give something. You have to give the right food. Otherwise, you will go to the bar or for sex or pornography or whatever your flesh is leading to. Because you want some satisfaction. Or you will go with your friends just for a moment of happiness. You visit your friends or relatives, or you take your mobile and keep talking. Nantu life inge, nintu life inge, nanu gottu, adru sumne, matadananda. Nenagu salpu relief sikthadalla, nanagu. ಏನ್ರಿ ಲೈಫ್ ಯಾಕೆ ಬದುಕಬೇಕು ಸಹಾಯಕ್ಕೂ ಆಗಲ್ಲ ಹಂಗೆ ಬದುಕ್ತೀವಿ ದಿಸ್ ಈಸ್ ಹೌ ದ ಕಾನ್ವರ್ಸೇಷನ್ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ಇಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಸ್ಲೋ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಗಿಯರ್ ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಗಿಯರ್ ಥರ್ಡ್ ಗಿಯರ್ ಫೋರ್ತ್ ಗಿಯರ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಫಿಫ್ತ್ ಗಿಯರ್ ಓ ದೆನ್ ದೇ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಬೂಸ್ಟ್ ಅಪ್ ಒಳ್ಳೇದಾಯ್ತಪ್ಪ ನಿನಗೆ ಫೋನ್ ಮಾಡಿದಿರುವುದು ನಾನು ಎಷ್ಟು ಡೌನ್ ಆಯಿತು ಗೊತ್ತಾ ನಿನ್ಗೆ ಫೋನ್ ಮಾಡಿ ನನಗೆ ಒಳ್ಳೆ ಎನರ್ಜಿ ಸಿಕ್ತು ಬನ್ನಿ ಮನೆಗೆ ನಾನು ಬರ್ತೀನಿ ಸ್ನ್ಯಾಕ್ಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಸ್ನ್ಯಾಕ್ಸ್ ಫಾರ್ ಅವರ್ ಸ್ಪಿರಿಟ್ fully sister or brother or a worldly person is fully energized. He thinks, ah, that is life. No, my friend, that is the hunger of the spirit. It is not that you have to go to your friend or to satisfy the craving of your flesh. You have to go in the presence of God. Don't think that it is hi-fi spiritual or hi-fi spiritual life. It is the minimum normal life every person needs. And young person is telling that, oh, I cannot live a spiritual life. Educated and hi-fi person will tell, I cannot live it. You need spiritual life. Otherwise your life is going to be dry, hard and happy. Plus sickness. Hospital. Medicine. Hallelujah. Friends, understand. So, when we face such longing, always we start looking for ways for the feelings to go away. Isn't it? In the sense, we begin to look for the junk food that will satisfy the urge of the spiritual hunger within us. The danger of this type of behavior is that we dull our sense of God. That emptiness is the desire, the hunger of the God, my friends. Understand? Stop giving junk food. Please understand. In the same way, the continual snacking through the day can dull your appetite and causes not to pass up a good nutritious meal that our physical body requires, isn't it? Keep eating junk food, so we cannot eat the good food that we have made. What will happen? We will not get enough food, health for our body, isn't it? And we will go through these empty feeling daily, and we do snacking through the day. So we often fill up the emptiness with the pleasure, outing, looking for satisfaction in all other wrong places, thus trying to satisfy the craving of our heart with the junk of this world. Or some so-called spiritual people, at such time, they don't do all these things. They will go in the presence of God. They will worship God and they pray and they will get some peace. Isn't it? You are enjoying that is also junk food. Why? So, this so-called spiritual sister or brother will go to the presence of God and they will ask for the immediate relief, and they say that they are spiritually strengthened, that they are spiritually malnutrition, they are not able to understand. Then what they have to do? The right place we need to go is the action that we need to take. It is to go to the source that is the bread of life. John 6, 35 and 41, Jesus said, I am the bread of life. He who comes to me will never go hungry. He who comes to me for what? For obedience, for righteousness, to change your life. He who comes to me with thirsty heart. So what you have to do at such time is you should go to your room. Whenever you feel such emptiness, don't go to bar or go to your friends or don't seek another girlfriend or boyfriend, or if you are married, don't seek another your girlfriend or men boy girlfriend or boyfriend. Okay, what you need is you need to go and have quiet some time with God. Matthew 6:6, you should ask God why you are going through such feelings and emotions. You should ask why you have no joy and peace and why you are feeling that dull feeling. Believe me, God will let you know what is happening in your life. If you spend some time asking these questions, God will make you understand what you are going through, why you are going through. He will give you the solution. He will reveal your heart's problem. He will reveal your sins to you. You have a craving for something. You have unforgiveness to someone. You are very impatient. When you go and sit before God only, you will understand. This quiet time you have to have with God. And God will let you understand what's happening in your heart. You should be ready to accept God's counseling. You should be ready to change. You should accept that. If you are not ready to change, this is of no use for you. Maybe your entire view of the life is wrong. And that gloominess and sadness you often feel is because of all this. You should understand and you should recognize and choose to feed on righteousness. So don't feel that, never snack. Never keep snacking for your spiritual hunger. This is for your own. See, please don't think that what I am speaking is a hi-fi spirituality. That is the reason you have to talk about Jesus Christ to the people. Jesus is not a Christian God. Jesus is the God of everyone. Jesus told, those who hunger and thirst for righteousness, they shall be satisfied. Who wants righteousness? Isn't it? You and me don't want a righteous life. We don't like to live a righteous life. We want to enjoy this world, living through our sin. But we don't know tomorrow what will happen to us. We don't know the importance of a righteous life. We think we cannot live the righteous life that is written in the Bible. Isn't it? Friends, understand that is the basic life, normal life. Every day we need to live. One of the greatest spiritual principles of God is to fast. Because when we fast, we become intensely aware of our physical hunger. That physical hunger can lead a spiritual hunger. That is the reason I tell most of you, all of you, to take fasting at least once a day for your own character. So what happens? When you skip a meal, you feel hungry. That you should turn to your spiritual hunger. You should spend time with God while you are fasting. You are fasting for more of God, you should understand. So what you need? Where you have to change? You have to understand. So you should understand and you will pray. That is called fasting. And it is God's principle, my friends, understand. So the physical hunger can lead a spiritual hunger as well. It is our need to fast as a means of waking us up to a greatest need of our righteous life. Spiritual fasting is to internalize righteousness. Also spiritual fasting, we have to spend in the spiritual fasting, we have to spend some time. Many people will fast and go for their work. Early morning you get up. If you are a working person, either breakfast you skip, afternoon though you cannot because you cannot sit anywhere and pray in the office, or night you skip the meals, but you see that you have physical hunger. That physical hunger should lead you to the spiritual hunger. Don't eat. Many people will eat half stomach or 3/4 stomach. That hunger should come. You should really feel like you want to eat something. That should help you to pray. Please understand that. And another thing is, the loss of appetite is a sign of illness. Physically, we know something is wrong when we have no desire to eat, isn't it? The same is true spiritually. If you do not feel like coming closer to God, and if you feel whatever I am preaching or such preaching have no sense, you may come and sit here, let her preach and go. Nothing, I will not obey. I will live my life. I will never change. I am like this. I am born like this. I will never change. You have a sickness, my friends, understand? You are not a healthy person. Whatever the food you eat, whichever the gym you go to build your body, that will not help you to build your body without the spiritual health. Please understand, my friends. So you may be thinking, or such preaching, they are all mad people. So if you don't feel like studying the word of God, if you have no interest to get alarmed of your sinful condition, or if you get offended, we give guidance to you people. I don't know whether you people are reading or not, but here I told you, I have assistant doctors. They have instrument. When they pray, they will get What is happening in your heart, that will be sent to you. I don't know whether you are reading or not. Please have humility to read and understand what is happening inside of you. Okay? And rectify them. So if you get offended of such spiritual guidances, if you are not interested to fast, to get hunger for more of righteous life, for your change in character, they are the clear sign that spiritually you are sick. You are a sick person seated here. If that is your mentality, that means you are not interested to have a relationship with God and to live a spiritual life. Please understand, you have a spirit. You have a soul. You can only see the body. Even you can feel the soul, because the soul is the place where we think. We don't think with our body. We think with our mind, that is soul. Inside, there is another person, that is spirit. God has made, or God has put spirit in every person to have relationship with God Almighty, my friends. Understand? All those who are ignoring that, they will never prosper. Understand, my friends? Hallelujah. So, such condition lead you to spiritual sickness, that lead you to spiritual illness. Finally, you will die spiritually because you are ignoring and suppressing the spiritual hunger. Spiritual hunger is there inside of you, my friend. You are not recognizing. All the time you are snacking. You get it. Just go. You may be having enough money also. No, now you are working. Why? What you cannot buy? So because you are ignoring and suppressing the spiritual hunger that God has put it in your heart, the danger of this type of behavior is the same as those who take Holy Communion without any commitment. That is said in 1 Corinthians 11, 27 through 30. Gradually in due course of time, what will happen? We will be spiritually weak, and that will affect ours. When we are spiritually weak, we look like this. Outside also, you may be having a good job. You may be having a good wife, but you are not satisfied with that wife. You may be having a good husband, but you are not satisfied with that husband. You may be having everything, but you are not satisfied with. Why, you know? Satisfaction you are lacking because of the spiritual weakness. You will be boosted. Even if nothing you have, you should have happiness. Friends, by birth, none of us have this. Don't think that I am born like this. I have practiced. Spiritual things we have to practice. Who are the righteous people? No one is born righteous. And if you take just baptism, you will not be a righteous person. You will start. You have to start walking a righteous life. Who is a righteous person? 1 John 3:7 says, those who practice righteousness in a daily way life, they are righteous people. Daily. Don't fight with God. Everyday humility. Every day humbling down before God to obey what God says. They are righteous people. So, the spiritual weakness will make you physical, will result in physical weaknesses. And weaknesses will result to illness, isn't it? Spiritual weakness will result to spiritual illness. That will result to physical illness. Understand, my friends? Whatever is happening inside our body, spirit has to bring the life to the body, my friends. Understand? Spirit. Spiritual life. It is not a religious life. It is not following rituals like the people of this world are doing. The spiritual life is a righteous life. Jesus told those who are hungry and thirsty of righteousness, they will be satisfied. Hallelujah. So, start recognizing your spiritual hunger, my friends. Never ignore it. You are leading yourself to a dangerous person. That's the reason I will always challenge you. You may go from this church, you may go from this sister Anu, but the principles of God will follow you anywhere you go. Please understand. You can escape from me because you may be fed up of hearing me because you are sick. Don't worry, you can be healed. This is a spiritual hospital. Church is a spiritual hospital. Yes, sick people only should come here. Weak people only will come here. We will give you injection. We will give you medicine. We will inject you. It is not just to get during the service. While you go from here, that effect of the injection will be there. Hallelujah. None of you are hearing once again this message. Go home and hear my message. My messages are so important for you to live a daily life. If you live that life, my friend, you will testify that this God is living for you. This God is for you. My friend, understand. This is the spiritual life. You don't want to live a spiritual life, but you want to live all the way to go and live a physical life. If you don't live a spiritual life, your physical life will be what? In tragedy, in due course of time. So start recognizing your spiritual hunger. You keep getting it. You keep getting that hunger. Start with repentance and recognizing your sins. Feed on righteousness. Let your righteousness get internalized in such a way that it gives life to your spiritual and physical being. Salvation begins with recognizing the hunger and thirst of the soul. Hallelujah. And don't be tired of looking around and seeing the misery of the people. Many of you are tired of seeing the misery of maybe your own family people or the friend circle. Don't be, because understand, they are not living a spiritual life. They don't even believe. You start living. Then you don't have to be in their misery. Please understand, many of you are down. Many of you are tired. Seeing your family people's misery and saying, why I should live? One day I too will be like that. Why that person is like that? Does he have a spiritual life? He may be having a ritual life and a religious life. Does he has a spiritual life? You will testify no, because look at his anger, irritation, all his character. Did he change? Is he living a godly life? As long as he is not living a godly life, he has to be in that condition. You should recognize that. And you start living a spiritual life and pray for such people, my friends. This is all you have to do. Looking at the misery of people, you should not lose your joy. God has created us and put us into this world and gave us all what he has given to enjoy this life, my friends. Enjoy the life. At the same time, pray for the people. Let's close our eyes in prayer.